We're going to go ahead and do this one with villains only, and they do reflect, so we do need to be careful of that, but I'm pretty sure that stage 16 Yellow Jacket can take care of this on the first try. So we're going to try Yellow Jacket here, Hawkeye, on stage 16. Hawkeye, Yellow Jacket does have mixed energy and physical damage with some of his abilities, so you do have to be quite careful when you're using his second skill, because at the very end, the last hit is not an iframe, and so if they have the reflect up as he does, you will take, I just took 5,000 damage there, and so you do need to watch out for that, because otherwise you'll die, and then you won't know why you died, and then you'll be sad because you died. I do need to kill, I didn't kill him. I really want to kill Kingpin because I don't want to die to reflect, but I think I might. If I can only hit Maestro, it's actually not that big of a deal, because he doesn't have reflect up. The bubble there is telling you who has reflect. Right now it's only Kingpin. But yeah, it's really important to learn how to kite in Shadowland, especially if you're a new player, because kiting, i.e. just running around the arena, can definitely come in handy, as it just did there for Hawkeye, aka Yellow Jacket. New uniform confirmed. Coming up on stage 17, and we've got Vulture. Vulture's going to take on Malekith with the type advantage, so I do think he'll have a pretty good time. I have a pretty well-built Vulture, so if you see numbers that you're not used to seeing in terms of damage, keep that in mind. I did give him quite a bit of a buff in terms of his uniform, in terms of his obelisk with a damage proc, and his Uru, because I was trying to use him for a Shadowland speedrun, because he has the versatile villain tag with speed, and he also has increased damage against superheroes with his uniform, which does make him quite good. However, I never got him to function successfully for a speedrun, so I wouldn't recommend it for you, but he can definitely do this stage at tier 1 with or without his uniform. Stage 18, Rumble. I wanted to pick the double gold reward, but it was a hero only stage, and I don't have many more characters that can bypass that requirement. And so because of that, I had to opt for this villain stage, which plays perfectly into this clear and is super easy for Enchantress to do. Enchantress has kind of been a forgotten character. I think she's kind of going to be maybe the next Hyperion in maybe 6 months to a year, because of the fact that she's a paywall character. She used to be amazing, and now she's basically worthless. She does have the meta charm effect. It's not 10 seconds of mind control, but it is 5 seconds on a low cooldown of about 5 seconds, which does make her forever useful on low world boss ultimate stages, but ultimately her damage is what makes her unusable at higher stages. Stage 19, and again, the middle stage was double gold with heroes only, so I wasn't able to take advantage of that, but we can take advantage of a show off of Killmonger, who I very rarely, if at all, ever get to use. He's kind of like Black Panther, I guess, but not quite as good. I think his skill rotation is a little bit more awkward than the King of Wakanda's, so that's generally why I don't like using him. I don't like using characters that jump around too much with their rotations. It's just kind of hard to keep track of, and I feel like they're more likely to get interrupted, more likely to get iframe kind of dodged, and also just bad tracking. He seems to have good tracking. He's kind of like X23 in the sense that he dives around a lot with his skills. He does have some nice abilities and some nice buffs against heroes and some nice self buffs. His damage is definitely not bad at all. I've got a 140 max HP proc, so he could definitely do even more. But yeah, I just never really got used to the character. He could probably do this at tier 1, but he definitely needs his uniform. On to stage 20, and we're going to try to use Ghost here with the shorter time, as you only have 1 minute on each stage. I am a little bit worried about her ability to kill these characters. She has the type disadvantage against 2 out of 3, but she does have a mythic uniform, and she does have some 4 and 5 star Uru, and she does have quite a bit of AoE, which allows her to deal damage to all of them. And like Mantis, she's very good at just locking her opponents down. As you can see here, they've literally not casted a single skill the entire time, which means that she could probably do this at tier 1 if you were able to stack up enough damage in time. I did that one pretty quickly in less than 20 seconds, so I do think it's possible, but it's just about the positioning and getting all those characters. Make sure they stay inside the green warning sign, because like Mantis, that is what is applying a lot of the buffs, and you can see as soon as I let them out or as soon as I stop casting it, they will stop getting stunned. But you can see so many buffs, so many debuffs getting stacked up on the right side there. It's pretty bananas. And she's a fun character for Shadowland, but doesn't have much use outside of that. Her support buff, sometimes a leadership, and the ABX speed villain tag. Moving on to stage 21, and we arrive at the first member of the Black Order that we want to intentionally use. We didn't actually want to use Corvus when we did, because it was a much lower level than I wanted, but we have Cull Obsidian here, and he just smashes stages. Lots of AoE, lots of hits, and I really like playing with him. It's got a bit of a Dragon Ball Z feel, and that third skill just dunks enemies, and he just erases the Asgardians plus Groot. On to stage 22, and we had the fire stage, so of course, who better to use than the King of Flames, at least from the villains. Okay, great, we did zero damage. Thank you, Dormammu. This stage is actually really frustrating. I have no idea what Corvus, what Carnage was doing there, but there we go. This is such a weird stage. Either it takes you 30 seconds and you get stunned 1,000 times, or you delete them both in one shot and you're just surprised at how insane the damage is. On to stage 23, it's a Hulk stage with blast type characters or universals and physical reflect, so we do have to be careful of that. So someone like Caecilius is probably out of the question. We could use Hela, I think, maybe, or Anti-Man, but I think I want to try to use Proxima and just use her iframes and have a lot of fun dodging these guys and hitting them. I don't think she has any physical attacks. Her second skill might have a bit of physical on it, but with all of her debuffs in terms of stuns and things like that, it should be a pretty easy clear. We just need to keep them under control here with all of these bouncing attacks and all of these stuns. Yeah, this isn't too hard. We just need to be careful because She-Hulk does have a couple of iframes and She-Hulk does have her reflect up. So now we could die to that, but I think we're fine. Level 70 helps a lot for Shadowland. So does a heroic uniform, and so does having a native tier 2. There we go. 30 second clear, very smooth, lots of iframes, and taking advantage of the stuns to kind of space out your attacks, pause in between each ability so you get those stuns in, you get those guard breaks, and you buy yourself more time before you loop back around and start the rotation again. Stage 24, we got Rocket Raccoon, and Apocalypse might be overkill here in terms of how fast this ends, but we did need the ignore dodge because he has very high dodge, and Apocalypse has 50% natively, so it's important to play to your advantages. And yeah, those big fists need to be used sooner or later. We arrive now at stage 25, made in this case, in my clear, for Thanos, because with one punch of his Titan, his Mad Titan ability, he wipes away the active buff, allowing him to deal damage to superheroes. I believe his uniform also gives him damage against superheroes, so he's got both of those things going for him, but I don't think he should be stumped in the second half of the fight as Corvus was, because he can delete the effect, he can delete the active buff like Doctor Strange can, and also because he doesn't have any clones anyway, so he wouldn't be able to do that. But you can see Thanos is a very versatile character as a universal villain who can also play hero stages. He can basically do every single stage in the game. He can even do female stages because with his first skill he deletes whatever buff they have, allowing him to compete wherever he wants, a la Doctor Strange. Stage 26, we had the choice between Kingpin and the kind of symbiote brothers. I thought it would be pretty funny to use a cold damage character in Loki rather than taking advantage of any kind of fire. So we kind of go the opposite way with ice, and he of course can still do it. He still has enough damage, he's got enough iframes, he's got enough crowd control with the frozen attack, with the chilling, with the guard hit up as well. And you can see the guard break from his clone's abilities is actually giving him a lot of additional CC. Those flying knives also do, and you know, Loki's no slouch, level 70. He can still get it done even though he doesn't have as much presence in the meta as he once did. And there you go, that's like a 35 second clear with Loki, and he gets a 4-star card to boot. Now stage 27 is difficult because it has an energy damage immunity tag, and I actually forgot to leave down a physical damage villain who can complete this stage, but it gives me the perfect opportunity to not only show off my build for Sentinel, but also to show you that even though I'm not doing any damage, the clones can do full damage despite the energy immunity, and despite the kind of reduction, they can pierce through it, they can do it all for me. and basically allows him to clear this stage with zero or just very little difficulty. And he can even do this at tier 1. So I think Sentinel is a pretty decent, if not very decent, selection for a bio subscription once you have, of course, already done both Ghost Panther and Luna Snow for different reasons. You might even consider using him after, or getting him after Ghost Panther before Luna Snow, because of his flexibility, his leadership, of course, and then you know, all this stuff. And he's just a really fun, interesting, unique character to play as. And he netted me 20 upgrade kits, which is not bad. Cue all of the Shadowland reward complaining comments. Stage 28, we pulled the Spider stage. I don't have any good combat villains left, so we are going to be using Anti-Man. He does have a CTP of... I didn't even use my immunity. What am I doing? This is the worst rotation ever. He has a CTP of energy, so I can use that to get some ignore dodge. And you can see just his raw damage is enough despite my horrible, horrible rotation. He's just got enough power in the can to juice all comers. And he's basically working a giant energy blender and just destroying everyone in it. And yeah, this is not the rotation you want to use for him, but it's the rotation that I'm using for Shadowland because I'm just trying to survive, man. Please hit him, please kill him. There we go. Anti-Man. Mostly for ABX, sometimes for other game modes. Second to last stage, I had to give it up to Morgan Le Fay. Very fun character to play as. I know a lot of you guys have invested in her, and I've already shown off what she can do, but it's always fun to do it again and to just blast the Black Order into oblivion with her abilities, as long as she doesn't... Wow, she instantly died. That's fun. I'm gonna have to hopefully not die against Thanos and his guys because I don't have any more lives. I think we're gonna do the iframe instead because I'm so terrified now of dying, and I don't want to die, so there's that. Please don't kill me. That would be great. No one's taking damage. That's also great. Why is no one taking damage? I healed myself, but I might still die. Okay, I didn't die. Why aren't you dying? Why is no one dying? Please do damage. Morgan Le Fay doesn't do any damage. Who would have thought? I would have thought. I told you guys. I told myself, and yet I'm still here. Okay, Morgan Le Fay's still here, so we're going to try to clear the second half of this fight. I don't know if we're going to make it. Sometimes Ebony Maw acts like a really huge asshole on this stage. Sometimes Thanos does too. Honestly, sometimes even Supergiant does. I have a CTP of energy, guys, and her damage is this bad. So yeah, damage, not good. Survivability, good. Skill effects, absolutely amazing. One of the coolest looking skill characters in the game. And there you go, Morgan Le Fay, stage 29, with a CTP of energy. That's not bad. Last but not least, stage 30, we're going to be using Magneto. I was considering using Scourge for the memes, but it was just really, really slow, so I didn't want to put you guys through that 2.5 minutes of trying to make jokes about Scourge while actually trying to survive against good old Daredevil iframe ignore guy who constantly iframes and blocks your attacks. So we're just going to melt him with a level 70 gear 25 Magneto. That's right, my Magneto is ready to tier 3. Am I going to tier 3 him? No. Stop asking. Or keep asking. And hey, for once I got decent rewards on the last stage of Shadowland. So let me know what you guys think. Did you like to clear all villains? You got a new theme for me? Subscribe if you enjoy the content and you want to support me. Hit the bell if you don't want to miss any of my videos. And of course, if you like what you see, I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.